today I have something a little different, the Creality CP-01. While it looks like a regular 3D printer, it's actually three machines in one, a 3D printer, a CNC machine, and a laser engraver. You know, I'm not one to read specs off the box. What matters is how it works in the real world. So let's unbox it and take a look. So here's the CP-01 3D printer user manual. Two box, a spool of filament, the aluminum bed, oh. 3D printing head, the gantry frame. Kind of heavy. Some protective glasses. So tight. CNC engraving, the CNC engraving head. So tight, has to be tight, because otherwise when you ship it overseas, there might be some problem. This one probably is the tightest package I've ever unboxed. What? This is the laser engraving head. So there are three functions in total, so three heads. This is the main frame. Okay, this print is not bad. You can see some stringy in here, but
over there, there's some bridging issue, but that's not the hardware issue. That's something to do with the slicer settings. When the community comes up with a better slicer settings, it won't be an issue anymore. But you gotta be aware, this is not a perfect print out of the box. You still need to take some time to dial the prints in, but it's a fixable print.
So right now we are in the Creality workshop. This is their program for importing the G-code file in there for the CNC and laser engraving function. Let me show you how you do it. So if you have something you want to engrave, like I have a husky I want to engrave. So this is my husky. I import it. Now this is for laser, and you know the size of the print volume is not huge. This exists a bit, so we need to scale it down. Scale it down to, about that. And then we put it at the corner. You want to zoom in? Of course you can. You can do that. See, all clear. See, you can zoom in like this. But the width and height is still the same. It's just to let you see it more clearly. So let's go to export setting. And this, you don't have to. This CNC travel Z means how high they lift the nozzle. And CNC print C is how deep it cuts. Travel speed 60 seems great. CNC laser, let's make it slower, 1 mm per second. Okay, after that, you're done. You can just export G-code, your G-code file, husky 111, and then save. Yay, export G-code finish. Then you just take it out and insert the SD card. You can start engraving. Okay, now let's get the laser head into position. Go to settings, move. All right, then we can engrave now. Check this out. It's nice and clean, but it uses dial laser, and I'm not a big fan of dial laser, but you're okay with that? The result is not bad at all. Okay, now let's head on to the CNC engraver. For CNC, it's the same. CNC, you go to here, CNC. And what you do, I'm going just to use the same picture, and we're just going to use the husky. But for CNC, I will make it go faster. I will make it go like 4 millimeter per second. And then same, you go here, you go to export G-code, husky 222. Then you save, export G-code finish. And then you take out your SD card and then plug it in, but and then you can set the Z height.
you double after you set the C high, you just double tap the nozzle icon, and then everything will just work.
Right now, let's go back to the menu. And go to Control, Hex Selection, CNC. Now we can select our file. As you saw, there are some flex in the spindle. We could deal with that by taking more passes. Overall, good enough. We all know about the problems with people getting unsubscribed and not being notified about videos. It's great if you can double check that and make sure you won't miss anything. But really, the best thing you can do to help me out is repost my videos where other people will appreciate them. Okay, so CP-01 pros and cons. Pros: rock solid platform, great build quality, first generation firmware that isn't buggy. Go Creality, love to see it. All three tools were as expected. It's a good 3D printer in need of better slicer settings, a good laser dial engraver, and a usable CNC engraver. There are no major mechanical or firmware issues out of the box. It will work as advertised, which is good to see. You know, often when it's a first generation machine, there are some bugs to iron out, and sometimes it's just flat out unusable. Not the case here, it's ready to go. So yes, if you want a 3D printer / CNC engraver / laser engraver, the CP-01 is a good bet and I can certainly recommend it. Cons: why? And this isn't specific to the CP-01, but all of these 3-in-1 machines. Why do we need this? The 3D printer, CNC, and laser engraver idea is a multi-tool created by two makers, not two users. It's easy to manufacture, that doesn't mean it's very useful. It's a bit like selling a 3-in-1 circular saw, bandsaw, jigsaw. Yes, they technically do different things, but what are you going to make with that? A 3-in-1 saw, drill, and sander? Now that's something you can make a ton of stuff with. The CP-01 is a fantastic platform, and I get the two choice for marketability given the success of similar machines. And it sounds good on paper, but I would love to see some more useful tool heads. Keep the 3D printing, optimize the CNC software for PCB engraving, and offer a manual pick and place head. I do a lot of surface mount soldering work these days. Plenty of guys want to give it a shot, but their hands are not so steady. A manual pick and place head with a micro screw webcam and rotating suction tip would be cheap and let anyone plays parts with just their computer mouse. This combination would actually let you build a huge range of hardware projects, from populated PC board to 3D printing enclosure, all on one compact machine. The great thing about the CP-01 is it looks like it can be open to third-party tool heads, and I'll certainly push Creality to make sure of this. There's a ton of potential applications for solid Cartesian framework that accepts interchangeable heads, paste extruders for clay and cooking applications, pipettes for lab work. It's just endless, so a huge amount of potential here. I just don't think that the free tool heads currently available really do it justice. There you have it. Thumbs up for the CP-01 with the caveats that I would like it to be opened, and I would like more tool heads with greater functionality. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all next time. And remember, if I can do it, anyone can do it.